Report, audio recordings show Russian officials suggested bribery to Bill and Hillary Clinton in exchange for favors. In an appearance Tuesday evening on Fox News program Hannity, author of Clinton Cash, Peter Schweizer told Sean Hannity that audio recordings reportedly show Russian officials suggesting they would be open to bribing Bill and Hillary Clinton in exchange for favors. Peter Schweizer, we now have this whistleblower that has come forward who reportedly has audio recordings of Russian officials talking about using bribery to get favors from the Clintons, giving donations to the Clinton Foundation. That has yet to appear, but I think that will be pretty strong. Partial transcript as follows via Breitbart News. Hannity, joining us now, the man who got this started, author of the book, Clinton Cash, Peter Schweizer, Fox News contributor, former deputy assistant to the president, Sebastian Gorka. Peter, you got this started, you watched this unfold today, and I want to get your initial reaction. I also want to talk about, I want you to give us the money aspect to this as it relates to the Clintons, who paid who, when and where, and how active and involved were they in this deal. Schweizer, well, look, Sean, I've always felt the evidence was very clear. And I don't know that hesitation is at the Department of Justice. There were several facts that no one debates. Fact number one. You have the Kazakh uranium minister Maltrets Hakishev in a 2010 video deposition describing in great detail how Bill and Hillary Clinton shook him down and shook down Kazakh officials to compel them to give uranium assets to Frank Gistera, who is the founder of Uranium One. Nobody disputes that. That is clear. We now have this whistleblower that has come forward who reportedly has audio recordings of Russian officials talking about using bribery to get favors from the Clintons, giving donations to the Clinton Foundation. That has yet to appear, but I think that will be pretty strong. The third part of this ingredient is we have the actual flow of money. Tens of millions of dollars to the Clintons as this deal is going down, Hannity, Mueller knew as the FBI director. It was an FBI informant. That means Holder had to know. They have not only has 4+ years experience as an undercover agent, informant, they also have tapes, and they also have documents, and they also have emails, and they slapped an NDA on this guy, like putting a muzzle on him. Wait until he now discloses this. I'm imagining this is devastating, Sebastian first, Hannity. It is so extensive because I keep talking about this dual justice system, Peter. It is the dossier, propaganda bought and paid for by Hillary and the DNC. It doesn't make sense to give away our uranium, ever. I'll give you the last word. Schweizer, yeah, you are exactly right, Sean. And look, the Clinton defense thus far has been pitiful. Essentially they say, first of all, 9 government agencies have reviewed this. That has nothing to do with bribery. The fact of the matter is bribery exists whether it's a close vote or not. The second offense, Hillary Clinton is saying that she was not involved in the decision. I'm sorry, but she does not have a great track record of speaking the truth. The person that they sort of prop out, Assistant Secretary of State Fernandez, to say she was not involved in this decision, 4 days before he first made that statement, Sean. He is in the Podesta email saying he wants to do whatever he can to help Hillary Clinton get elected. He is not a disinterested party. This has to be investigated. News of the alleged recordings comes amid reports Attorney General Jeff Sessions has ordered senior federal prosecutors to evaluate whether or not a special counsel should investigate the Uranium One deal and alleged unlawful dealings related to the Clinton Foundation. Representative Jim Jordan, R.O. grilled Attorney General Jeff Sessions Tuesday on the alleged crimes connecting the Clinton campaign, the Democrat Party, the FBI, James Comey and the Russian dossier. As the Gateway pundits Jim Hoft reported, Rep. Jordan laid out the specific crimes of collusion committed by FBI and DNC operatives in 2016. Jordan pointed out the fake dossier and asked AG Sessions if this was the impetus to spy on the Trump campaign. Sessions would not answer. At the end of the questioning Rep. Jordan asked Sessions if he would appoint a special counsel to investigate this deviant activity by the FBI and DNC. Sessions told him he would not appoint a special counsel. Representative Jim Jordan, doesn't that warrant an addition to all the things we know about James Comey in 2016, doesn't that warrant naming a second special counsel? AG Jeff Sessions, I would say what it looks like is not enough basis to appoint a special counsel. As the Gateway Pundit reported, disgruntled Republican lawmakers are beginning to voice the same displeasure over the inaction of Attorney General Jeff Sessions as many conservatives have for months. The calls for Sessions to investigate the corruption surrounding Hillary Clinton and James Comey are growing louder. On Monday, GOP Congressman Jim Jordan and Matt Gaetz called on Sessions to probe the FBI's investigation into Hillary Clinton private email use or resign.